Hi, this is Justin McWilliams, and I'm going to present a case of using the NEUWAVE Ablation Confirmation Software to help ablate an essentially invisible lesion. This was a 75-year-old male. He has hepatitis C cirrhosis, child class A. He had first presented to us back in July 2016, at which time he had multifocal HCC, which was successfully ablated. A new lesion appeared 2 years later, which we also ablated, and he then presents another year after that with a new 1.2 centimeter lesion in segment 4A, which is seen in the images on the right. This was a LI-RADS 4 lesion, but given his history of recurrent lesions, we determined that it was quite suspicious and chose to ablate it. We took him for ablation, and we do our ablations under both ultrasound and CT guidance. Under ultrasound, the lesion was completely invisible, could not see it. And also on non-contrast CT, there was no visibility of the lesion whatsoever. Our typical preference is to then follow with a on-table dual-phase contrast CT. And in this case, we actually could not see it on the CT either. So this was a lesion that was only visible on MR. In this case, we just ended up attempting an ablation based on anatomic landmarks. We used a single PR probe and placed it to our expected location of the lesion, performed an ablation, but sure enough, on follow-up imaging, we determined that we actually had missed the lesion. Our ablation zone, which you can see in the green circle, is just adjacent to, but not really touching or engulfing the lesion, which is within the red circle. The lesion, meanwhile, has continued to grow and is now 1.4 centimeters. So we chose to bring the patient back for a repeat attempt at ablation. And on this time, we could faintly visualize the lesion on non-contrast CT using full dose. And so we marked that lesion using the ablation confirmation software to help us target it. The way I like to do this when we can't see it on ultrasound, but we were able to target it based on CT, is that we can use the ablation confirmation software to target the lesion. And usually I start just by using ultrasound to get my probe into the liver in the correct general direction. Even though I can't see my target, I just get it pointed towards the direction I need to go. And then I use the ablation confirmation software, and these three-dimensional views are quite useful for this. So this is a top-down three-dimensional view, and it shows that my initial trajectory is to anterior. It's going to end up a little in front of the lesion. And on the frontal view, it's also a bit inferior, so it's going to end up below the lesion. So I make adjustments based on that ACS targeting, and we reposition our probe and advance it. And now our ACS software shows us that the probe is now at the near margin of the lesion. And on the top-down 3D view, it looks to be on target, headed right for the center, and also on the frontal view, quite well located just at the near edge. So we go ahead and advance our probe. In this case, we decided to do two adjacent ablations to make sure we get a good ablation zone, especially given the difficulty in visualization. So we advance first into the superior aspect of the lesion. The 3D views confirm that the probe is well positioned in the superior posterior aspect of the lesion, and we perform a 5-minute ablation at 65 watts. We then withdraw and re-advance the probe into the inferior anterior aspect of the lesion, and we confirm that also with the ACS three-dimensional views. We perform a 65-watt, 5-minute ablation in that location. And at the completion of our procedure, while the patient is still under anesthesia, we perform a contrast CT, which shows a good ablation zone. And we can use our ablation confirmation software to compare our ablation zone with the known location of the lesion. And we can see that we did encompass the lesion, although our medial margin was relatively small. We could have advanced the needles a little farther and got a better margin on the medial side. But still, we were quite happy with this, especially given the shrinkage of the lesion that can occur with microwave. On the three-dimensional views using ACS, we confirm that the lesion is completely engulfed by the ablation zone. This is our follow-up MR performed later the same day, and it confirms that our lesion is completely within the ablation zone, and this patient has followed up once since then and remains free of recurrence. So a successful use of the ablation confirmation software to target a lesion that was invisible on ultrasound and only faintly visible on CT.